people. And we didn't run away. All of us, but we were over then to get about 4 weeks. We were staying together. I mean, we had we eat what we could. We still had some flour. And then they give out a report, as every Jew has to go, was a big, big temple over there, Swadesh. This temple was opened only once a year. And every Jew had to go to this temple. And over there was the SS and the Germans. And whatever we had over there, they told us we should throw away. We couldn't have nothing with us left. Then they took us to the transport. They took us to the trains, and they loaded to go to, we didn't know where about when we going. They took to Auschwitz, to Birkenau. And when we come to the transport, they put in about 60, 70 in a wagon, and we went straight, we didn't know where we going. When my father was in the First World War, he was 1958 born, he was about 55 years old. My father was a very smart man, and the wagon where they took us to Auschwitz, he looked through the little window, it's like a kettle, the wagon. So he said, it's no good. He recognized the area from the First World War, as they took us to Deutschland. And took 2 days, it was 3,000 transport. There were so many wagons I'm talking wagons, it's from the wagonen. A wagon is for the load and the things. We took 2 days and we arrived to Auschwitz. Birkenau, Auschwitz. When we arrived over there, we didn't have no food, no nothing. In the beginning, when we went in the wagons, the other people who didn't go with this transport was 4 transports. So they give us a piece of bread, a piece of bread, and this is what we had. We had no water, no nothing. It was very, very hard. We couldn't go to the people we had to do. So they went in a corner, and we had a blanket. We arrived to Auschwitz. When we arrived to Auschwitz, we didn't know where we are. It was every transport, every day arrived 3,000 people to Auschwitz, to Birkenau. They said we should go. All of a sudden, they opened up the doors, and everybody rose. We didn't know where we are. We didn't know where we are. Everybody was looking for the family, because when they put us in the wagon, they split up the mishpocha. It was crying, this and this. So we saw over there Jewish people, but the Polish people who was in the ghetto before us, they was wearing heftlike zaken. The clothes was striped. So one come to my father and he said, how old are you? He said, 55. He said to my father, he said, you better say you're not 55. So we saw over there the crematoriums. He said, you know what, everybody will, over there you're going, over there, they will kill you. So they took us of a lot, and they put the, in the line, man extra, Frauen extra, man extra, and woman extra, 5 in a line. We still didn't know what was going on. And when we were in the line, I was with my father, my brother, and my uncle, and my cousin. My cousin lives in Canada now. We was waiting. We didn't know where we were waiting. So my mother went out from the line, from the help between the ladies, and she went to my father and he said, Usher, I know you're going to remain alive. I don't know from where, she's been a year, she was a Sadakistan. She said, you go best take care of the two boys. And she was with the four sisters. And she said, me, I'm giving my whole heart to God, whatever he wants, he should do. So she said to my father, one thing I want for you, I want a heilig apart from Hemsleinen, because my father was a very, very big learner. He stammed from the Meir Shai, one of the schönsten Mishpoches, the Maramurish. And we are Rüssel Tzadik. And I will a heilig of Vienna werden für mich, von da lernen. My father promised it. And she didn't go by about 10 minutes, Dr. Mengele arrived. We didn't know Dr. Mengele was an officer. Then I know that he selected who goes to live, who goes to death. So he said, he came, he stayed in the front, he had a glass, and he had a stick in the hand, polished boots, over polished, and he said, Vorgang. So people about before us, he sent people, older people sent left, young people, well, he looked at them and he said he still have strength to work, because the Germans work is because they were beaten already, and to ride. So me, and my brother, and my cousin, he sent the right, and my father and uncle, he sent left. My uncle went right away, he didn't ask questions, he went. So my father didn't move. So Dr. Mengele told him why he's not moving. So my father said, I'm not moving because I want to see where my two children going. So he looked at him and he said to him, come see here. This means he should come near to here. Was any he from Baruf? He asked him what kind of work he did. My father said, Feldsarbeit. This means if I was a farmer. Father didn't know from farmer, I know from Schuster. So he looked him in the hand and he looked him in the face and he told my father, Geiser, right, with the young. So my uncle went to left. They people who want to left, they went right away in the morning to the crematories. Who want to lie to right, they put us in the barracks. And then first they took us to take baths. We didn't know what kind of baths. We had to take a shower, cold shower. And they cut us off the hair from the head. Only they cut off the head, and in the middle of the head, they left the one tool with the machine, because in case you go away, the Germans, they recognize we are Jewish. So we were over there about 7 days. Matter of fact, I went in the barrack, and I went from the barrack, and I didn't know where to go in. And I started to cry. Tata, and I looked till I find my father. Met my brother in the barrack. I didn't know which barrack, but so many barracks over there. Barrack just means our building where the store the Jewish people. And but we were over there for 7 days, and then the people who they sent the right, the German factories needed workers, and they selected 20 people goes to this factory, 20 people goes to this factory, and they send one thing, the whole together, my father and brother, we didn't want to be separated. My mother, they sent left with two sisters, one sister from 16 and one sister from 8. They sent them right to the crematory. My other two sisters, the elder sisters, they sent right. We didn't know it. And they sent them to a labor camp. Matter of fact, my two sisters died One day before the American came into Belgium, Eisenhower liberated Belgium.